The TPX magazine adapter. I was getting a lot of requests of this. Personally, I didn't really have much interest in it because I don't really like the magazines anymore. They are functionally really good, but the capacity is lower than like compared with TMC magazines, things like that. And I'm really used to that now, so I don't use it so much anymore. But at the same time, recognize it's quite a popular magazine, and so because of the request, things like that, I think okay, let's make it. I did not really get much support for it, but I did get some donations, so I'm really thankful for those people who helped out. Did not really cover the cost for everything, but still every bit helps. So yeah, let's start and show you how the product looks like, how to install it, things like that. I have made two editions. One, like I always start out with this one, the Brandstyle magazine is just sitting right on top, and I have made also the bold edition with dual Mac covers, and I will show you later why that's relevant. I think I want to show more this one, and it's not completed yet, so let's dive in the installation process first, and then I will show how it works. It's quite simple, put a magazine in, but still, huh? Okay, you print your desired magazine adapter body, so it could be one on top, the one on the left, things like that. Clear out the supports, of course. With this one, of course, you need to take away the supports, but at the same time, it should be fitting quite nicely without any adjustments, things like that. The tolerances are loose enough that it should fit without any problems. This part should be okay as well when we talk about fitting inside of the body. This part is a little bit more, and this is actually the Mac catch, is a little bit more tight. It's more tied to, let's say, the Mac catch arm. It's you need to make sure that this part wants to move like this easy, without any friction. Just use a knife, take out the supports, scrape a little bit. You don't want to make it too loose, but at the same time it should move nice and smooth. Also, make sure that there's no elephant foot or other things, imperfections, so this part can move really easy inside of here. You can also do this by going inside of here and just clean it a little bit out. If that is done, then okay, nice. You first, like the other magazine adapters, first place this part in. What I like to do is hold it against the light and see when this first part is blocking the incoming light, and then you see again, you'll see some light, and that is your indication that that's the hole, actually the hole you want to place the pin inside. Of course, you can also make sure just afterwards by pulling on it. If it doesn't pull out when you have a pin installed, then you have done a good job, it's inside. For me now, because it's just a demo, I will just take a longer wire and turn it so it doesn't fall out. But of course you can just take a wire, cut it, melt it with an iron, or glue it in, just what you want. So long it just stays inside there, then it's okay. You can install the arm when this is pulled back, and don't install it fully yet. First, install this this tiny part. Yeah, align it that's in the side of the hole. How you will make, how you can see that it's the right way is when this smooth, and also the you can see that it doesn't focus. You can see the angle part that needs to be on the top, so the magazine pushes it up on the side when you install the magazine. So you can also install it like this. You place it inside like this. Just that's probably the more easy way to do it. Yeah, and then install it like that. You can already place a spring inside. Just compress it and slide it in. And just help it a little bit, because it's not always goes right in. Then you need to push it a little bit in the hole. Now this time it really doesn't want to go in. So you could say, let's retry it. Sometimes that happens, but I've done quite a few of them. It should not be too hard, but sometimes it doesn't really want to slide in the right way. Just compress the spring. Yeah, now fits in right the right way at first. But sometimes it happens that it's kind of slips sideways, you don't want to do it, so then just take it out. Okay, then install the next pin. I need to straighten it a little bit. So, and then you install the pin and you got yourself a working magazine. So it's yeah, it moves quite in easy. It locks in place with any type of magazine. So yeah, that's it. I know this looks really big, but yeah, that's for the dual magazine thing. But it works for the 12 round magazine, the Zeta Mag, without any problems. The difference with this one is, if you look really closely, is that there is no pin right here. And that's just because this is still, let's call it a prototype. I was making this one and then realizing when you push the button, it's possible that this will slide out. So that's why I made this little pin right there, so it's no longer possible. So that's maybe, if in case you saw that, that's a difference, there's an upgrade, and all the designs on Thingiverse have that one. So yeah, the installation was quite the same as with the other Magwells. It's kind of mixed between the Helix Mag adapter and the TMC T15 magazine adapter. Maybe it was not really necessary to make the tiny part, but I had some trouble with the locking. So I was thinking, well, just take that little part inside of there that makes it for really smooth action. And yeah, so it's there, and it's really easy to take the magazine in now, and it locks. So just what you wanted, and yeah. So it works, and that's an important thing. It's already out there for the TMC, for the Cyclone Feed, I mean, for the Tippmann 98 adapters, all the other designs, and as you can see, also for the Bolt and the Hurricane. For those two editions, there's also like a dual Mac cover edition. Now let's show it right now. So when you have dual Mac couplers, they only work for this type of adapters, because when you use it in the TPX, You cannot grip your pistol grip anymore. That's for one. If you put in this magazine, where do you place your hand? It needs to be in between or something. That doesn't work. And also, the magazine coupler is sitting too high for the mag for the Tippmann Magwell hand grip. It's too long. Doesn't work. So don't try that. It doesn't work. But for this, it works. And what the coffers are for is to protect your paintball from dust, rain. If somebody shoots on it with paintballs, then it's at least, it maybe still cracks the paintball because of the force or something like that, but it doesn't create all the paint inside and things like that. I think actually it should protect it quite well because it's resting on the side, not on the top. So it also protects your paintball head, because if it sticks out and somebody really shoots at it, it may break. So I do recommend that you use that when you use dual mag covers. Of course, with the other designs, I did not really bother by, because if you use it on this one. It's pointing downwards, so let's say rain and dust. Okay, it already falls down. When somebody shoots in this angle, it's really an odd angle. It can happen, of course, but and it doesn't really have the room for it. It makes it too complicated to make a nice universal design that makes clearance for the feet neck adapter, things like that. It was getting way too crazy. Of course, it will fit in the magazine adapters, but make sure, of course, that you have a magazine adapter and marker combination to work. So if you have the on the side one, that it doesn't start to hit your marker or anything like that. If you have like the cyclone feet one that points down, then I don't think you can use it, because this one is fine, but when you start to use this one, it will start to hit your marker. So that one would not work. But in some cases, just use your mind and imagination. If I use it on this marker in this way, will it still fit? Same if you use this magazine adapter, but the backwards one, is it starting to hit the back of my marker? Probably it is. But if you use it on the side, yeah, you can still use the mag couplers. So yeah, that's your own judgment, what is smart to do and not. Besides that, it's now two magazines. I probably, if I use it on the top like this, just use one. Then you can use, you look a little bit past it. Now it's really a big thing to look at. But that's how it looks. It's angled backwards. I found it a little bit nicer than just straight up with the top one. But the other ones are just like straight, but then pointed in sideways, things like that. You will see it. And yeah, this is for the Bolt and the Hurricane. They have with the dual mag covers, as shown before. If you use just one magazine, you get also an edition without the covers. What I do like about how the Magwell turned out is that you can place your hand really around it, like it's almost like a pistol grip. And when you do that, it doesn't really interfere with the button. It's lower, so it should not be. And you can place your finger on the Mag release arm as well, to ensure that you don't lose your magazine. So that's kind of nice. And if you do want to drop the magazine, you can just lower your hand and pull the magazine straight out. And that's it. So yeah, that covers it. I think I talked way too long about it. It's just a magazine adapter. Now you know how to install it, how it looks, and how it functions. And yeah. If you like to support my work, please donate, because I do need some support to keep it all going with all the printing, prototyping and printing materials. I really made this series on really on a budget, so it was a lot. Maybe there are still some errors here and there, because I cannot test print it. I can only make a few test prints and I have to base everything on that because I simply don't have the budget to make a lot of test prints. It should all work, but there may still some errors here and there because I simply cannot test it. And so yeah, now's the thing. Now you have to print it and find out if it works or not. So yeah, it's no other way to work around that. So yeah, hope you like it. You can see the links below to find it. If you want to see the donation information, you can download the files and there's a text document, README file, and there you can see contact information and also donation information. So if you have like questions or requests, I do listen to it. Of course, if you send me a nice donation and you say I want to like to see this and this, I may take it more seriously. It's not, of course, that I start and make things for free that I don't have any use for it. But if you have like I seriously want to have this and I'm willing to pay for it, of course. I want to make things. I like to design things, and if it makes sense for me to make it, and if I expect that besides your donation I may get some more donation in the future for that project, then I'm more than willing to be interested in the project. So yeah. Let me know if you have that, if you have a request, things like that. Doesn't mean that I go in for every request. Some things I think like, yeah, that's a little bit too complicated or not realistic or a little bit too, let's say, but only for you interesting and for probably nobody else, and that's not really the budget. It's probably more interesting for yourself to learn how to make things like that. And yeah, I'm still planning to make the movies about how I use the programs, but yeah, things came up and then this I get some donations for this project. So I was thinking, now let's don't disappoint those guys and just start making this thing. And yeah, there it is. So yeah, the movies will come, but it may take some time.